Today's Sunshine Note is titled A Twice Broken Nose with No Painkillers. Then Haggai, the Lord's messenger, gave this message of the Lord to the people. I am with you, declares the Lord. Haggai 1:13. This is what I covenant with you when you came out of Egypt, and my spirit remains among you. Do not fear. Haggai 2:5. It was just about the worst possible scenario I could imagine. In the course of a single accident, I had broken both my left arm and my nose. My face had a kind of flattened look to it, with the cartilage and bone of my nose smashed into little crumbly pieces. It had been 2 weeks since the accident, and my nose had started to heal in the shape that it was smashed. I knew that the doctor needed to do something drastic, but I didn't know exactly what. As I sat back in the dentist-type chair, he peered casually through his glasses at my busted nose. Hold on to something, this is going to hurt quite a bit. And suddenly his hand was reaching for my face, his fingers poised like he was going to playfully pinch my nose. Instinctively, I grabbed for the armrest, realizing that whatever was happening would happen without any painkillers. Instead of cold metal, I found my mother's hand, firmly grabbing mine with all the love that could be communicated through fingers alone. I'll leave out the gruesome details, but suffice it to say that with all the awful crunching and popping, the feel of my mom's support got me through the haze of pain the way nothing else could have. Haggai's book is only 2 chapters long, but in those few words, he calls the people to look through their pain and start the process of rebuilding their faith and their lives. By then, 18 years had passed since they'd returned to rebuild Jerusalem, but the temple itself, the house that symbolized their true source of healing and protection, still lay in a pile of rubble left by Nebuchadnezzar and his armies. People were distraught. Twice in his message, Haggai tells the people that God is saying to them, I am with you, as he'd said to their ancestors just days after their liberation from Egypt. All through these minor prophets, God assures both them and us that he is with us no matter what circumstances surround our lives. If you get nothing else from these prophets, the thing they practically scream is that God is always present, always loving through the pain, and always reaching out to people who may or may not even be paying attention. May God bless you today.